Let us each reflect your light. May our prayers come before you, O God, as incense. And may your presence surround and fill us, so that, in union with all creation, we might sing your praise and your love in our lives. Amen. Our first reading is from the 18th chapter of 1 Kings. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come closer to me." And all the people came closer to him. First, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been thrown down. Elijah took 12 stones, according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord came, saying, "Israel shall be your name." With the stones, he built an altar in the name of the Lord. Then he made a trench around the altar, large enough to contain 2 measures of seed. Next, he put the wood in order, cut the bowl in pieces, and laid it on the wood. He said, "Fill 4 jars with water, and pour it on the burnt offering and on the wood." Then he said, "Do it a second time." And they did it a second time. Again, he said, "Do it a third time." And they did it a third time, so that the water ran all around the altar and filled the trench also with water. At the time of the offering of the oblation, the prophet Elijah came near and said, "O Lord, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your bidding. Answer me, O Lord, answer me, so that this people may know that you, O Lord, our God, and that you have turned their hearts back." Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, the wood, the stones, and the dust, and even licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and said, "The Lord indeed is God. The Lord indeed is God." The word of the Lord. Our psalm this evening is Psalm number 22, verses 25 through 31. From you comes my praise in the great congregation. My vows I will pay before those who fear him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek him shall praise the Lord. May your hearts live forever. All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall worship before him. For dominion belongs to the Lord, and he rules over the nations. To him indeed shall all who sleep in the earth bow down. Before him shall bow all who go down to the dust, and I shall live for him. Posterity will serve him. Future generations will be told about the Lord and proclaim his deliverance to a people yet unborn, saying that he has done it. The word of the Lord. Our third and final reading is from the 2nd chapter of Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. These days, the act of bending the knee usually means a marriage proposal or a Game of Thrones reference. But the tradition of bending the knee goes back much further than you might think. In the medieval era, knights would bend the knee before their king or their feudal lord as an act of respect, obedience, and loyalty. In religious worship, bending the knee before the Lord our God was and still is an act of submission to God as we lift up our prayers and our praise. Across many different times in human history, bending the knee has been an act of reverence and a declaration that you are superior to me and I will follow your leadership. So the question is not the action of bending the knee. The question is, how can we be confident that all peoples will bend the knee before Jesus? This story from 1 Kings gives us a great starting point. At this point in history, we are on the seventh king of Israel during the time of the split kingdom, Israel in the north and Judah in the south. While some of Judah's kings are remembered fondly, Israel's kings are mostly known for leading the people away from the Lord. The worst of these kings over the northern kingdom of Israel was Ahab, who married Jezebel and joined her in worshiping Baal and Asherah. Ahab built several altars to these foreign gods and led the people of his kingdom in worshiping these gods. So Elijah, the Lord's prophet, issued a challenge to Ahab. Have your prophets of Baal build a wooden altar. Prepare a sacrificial bull and put it on the altar. But do not set your altar on fire. I will also build an altar. Prepare a sacrificial bull and put it on my altar. Then have your prophets pray to your God, and I will pray to my God. The God that responds first by lighting their followers' altar on fire will be known as the one true God. Well, Ahab accepted the challenge and directed the 450 prophets of Baal to build an altar and prepare the sacrifice. Once they were ready, the prophets began to dance, calling out to their God. But there was no response. Elijah mocked them, wondering if Baal was asleep or otherwise preoccupied so that he could not hear his prophets. In response, the prophets of Baal wailed all the louder. They started cutting themselves so that blood flowed from their skin, hoping that this would get Baal's attention. But still, there was no response. After some time, Elijah built an altar with 12 stones. He laid out the wood and prepared his sacrificial bull. Then he took an odd step. He had the altar soaked with water until there was a trench full of water around the altar. And finally, he prayed to the Lord. And as Elijah finished his prayer, the Lord set the altar on fire. And that fire burned so hot that it consumed the wood, the bowl, the water, and even the stones of the altar. After a display like that, it's hard to argue that another God is greater than the Lord. Psalm 22, which we also read this evening, is attributed to King David, writing shortly after the Lord saved his life. However, we can also read the psalm from the perspective of Elijah, and imagining every land, every nation, every person living or deceased, bending the knee and worshiping the Lord after witnessing such an incredible sight. As impressive as the Lord consuming Elijah's altar with fire was, what Jesus did for us was even greater. Jesus, who was and is of the same being as God the Father, emptied and humbled himself by being born into the world as a human being. He pointed many people to the Lord's true nature, a God who loves humanity and who rules creation through mercy and righteousness, rather than through the power of the sword. And when the religious authorities arrested him and arranged his crucifixion, Jesus obediently followed his mission to redeem the Lord's people to its inevitable end, his death. This is where we expect the story to end. But Jesus rose from the dead, demonstrating his power over any power in the world, even the one great constant of death. For this, the name of Jesus, which literally translates to "He saves," is now the name above every name. Because of this great act, greater than the consumption of Elijah's altar by heavenly fire, every heavenly being and every human being, whether living or deceased, will bend the knee in submission, respect, and honor to Jesus as the one true King and authority when Jesus raises the dead and brings the Lord's kingdom to earth at the end of the age. In that moment, act of showing honor and loyalty to another will say everything that needs to be said. Amen. The light shines in the darkness,
and the darkness has not overcome it.
Rejoice, O highly favored, for God.
Merciful God, source and ground of all goodness and life, give to your people the peace that passes all understanding, and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. God, remember us in your love, and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless our God. Love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.